Dan
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam.
Let me introduce myself. My name is Marcel Gustino Ferdo. I'm from class 5C, group 7, Information, Communication, and Technology in Language Teaching. Today we will present our group result with the member. Next slide, please. The first one, me, Marcel Gustino Ferdo, Royana Siti Zahra, Sarah Alfi Mawati Zikri, and Windy Puspitasari. Next. The first material will be read by Zikri.
Okay, thank you, the moderator. So, for the first slide, is what is Eliza chatbot? Eliza was one of the first chatbot implementation. Joseph Eisenbaum created it at mid in the mid 1990s. The original version was in MATLAB, a list processing extension to the MAT programming language, but it has been ported to many languages. It's best known in combination with the Doctor Script, which simulates a psychotherapist. With an original article on Eliza is available but requires a purchase. The original source code seems close to the internet, but a Java port by Charles Hayden claims to be a complete and faithful implementation. It uses the original script file slightly reformatted. So, Eliza processing circle. The main loop accepts user input, it generates a response, it breaks the input into sentences and scans its sentence for keywords or phrases. It implements a list of synonyms to match equivalent words. For each case, it looks for a decomposition pattern, a meaningful way to decipher a sentence. It doesn't perform programmer parsing operation. Instead, it performs simple pattern matching operation. In some cases, all it can do is use the key itself to generate the valid response. If there is more than one key, Eliza chooses the match with the largest weight that can be parsed. A list are typical linguistic internet computer entity, also known as a list bot, or simply a list is a natural language processing chatterbot, a program that engages in conversation with humans by applying some heuristic pattern matching rules, human input. It was inspired by Joseph Eisenbaum, classic Eliza program. It is one of the strongest program of its kind and has won the Lavner Prize awarded to a talking humanoid robot 3 times in 2000, 2001, and 2004. This program cannot pass the Turing test because even a casual user will often reveal its mechanistic aspect in short conversation. Eliza was originally compiled by Richard Wallace. It came to life on November 23. 1995. The program was rewritten in Java starting in 1998. The current incarnation of Java implementation in program. The program uses an XML schema and AIML artificial intelligence markup language to define heuristic conversational rules. All this code has reportedly been available as open source. AIML results are available from Elise AI Foundation on Google Code. And from Richard Wallace, GitHub account, this AIML files can be run using an AIML interpreter such as program O or program B. So the other types of chatbots. First is Alexa chatbot. Alexa is officially a chatbot. Recently, Amazon started revealing another component. I use that empowers clients to type the request into Alexa and see reaction on the screen. This is yet another update that Amazon is making this year. It's Alexa first social app as the organization seeks to expand the utility of voice partners through the home. Many clients will also find it important accommodation because the current Alexa administration can be accessed silently. Others will ask why chatbots are such a fundamental update. The next slide will be presented by Raina.
Thank you, Zikri. What is Turing test? The Turing test is a method of inquiry in artificial intelligence, or AI, for determining whether or not a computer is capable of thinking like a human being. The test is named after Alan Turing, the founder of the Turing test, and an English computer scientist, cryptanalyst, mathematician, and theoretical biologist. According to Wikipedia, the Turing test, originally called the imitation game by Alan Turing in 1915, is a test of a machine ability to exhibit intelligent behavior equivalent to or indistinguishable from that of a human. Turing proposed that a human evaluator would judge natural language conversation between a human and a machine designed to generate human-like response. Next slide. The evaluator would be aware that one of the two partners in conversation was a machine, and all participants would be separate from one another. The conversation would be limited to a text-only channel, such as a computer, keyboard, and screen. So the result would not depend on the machine ability to render words as speech. If the evaluator could not reliably tell the machine from the human, the machine would be said to have passed the test. The test result would not depend on the machine ability to give correct answer to question, only on how closely its answer resembles that a human would give. Why Turing test is important? Turing test is important in demonstrating the intelligence of a machine and whether it can think like a human. This is usually done through interrogation. The test requires participants such as human interrogators and a computer. It also requires a site where the participants are kept in a safe place. Loebner Prize. What is Loebner Prize? The Loebner Prize is an annual competition in artificial intelligence to find the chatbot considered by the judges to be the most human-like. According to Wikipedia, the Loebner Prize was an annual competition in artificial intelligence that awards prizes to the computer program considered by the judges to be the most human-like. The prize is reported as defunct since 2020. The format of the competition was that of a standard Turing test. In each round, a human judge simultaneously hold textual conversation with a computer program and a human being via computer. Based upon the response, the judge must decide which is which. The next is will present by Windy.
Oh, the next is Marcel. Please present.
Okay, thank you. The contest was launched in 1990 by Hugh Loebner in conjunction with the Cambridge Center for Behavioral Studies, Massachusetts, United States since 2014. It has been organized by the AISB at Bletchley Park. It has also been associated with Flinders University, Dartmouth College, the Science Museum in London, University of Reading and Manchester University, Menji Campus, Derry, UK City of Culture in 2004 and 2005. It was held in Loebner's apartment in New York City. Within the field of artificial intelligence, the Loebner Prize is somewhat controversial. The most prominent critic, Marvin Minsky, called it a publicity stunt that doesn't help the field along. Next. Alan Matheson Turing. Who is Alan Matheson Turing? Alan Matheson Turing in Maidfala, London, England, a graduate of Princeton University, is a mathematician, computer scientist, and war hero. Alan Matheson Turing, the man who was known as a genius since childhood, was one of the first people to use computers for various purposes. Alan is indeed a very influential figure in the development of modern computers. Next. In 1930, he succeeded in making a machine called the Turing machine. This machine can execute simple commands. This engine can be a tool for transforming and manipulating basic abstract symbols. In 1936, Turing presented a book with a title on computable numbers with an application to the Einstein's problem, which dealt with universal machines, nothing but universal Turing machines or Turing machines. Turing later studied mathematics and cryptology at the Institute for Advanced Study in Princeton, New Jersey. After receiving his PhD from Princeton University in 1938, he returned to Cambridge and worked at the Government Code and Cipher School, a British organization for breaking codes. Next. After graduating from Princeton University, Alan Turing returned to England and worked in the UK Department of Communications. During World War II in 1939 until 1945, he was given the task of deciphering the information contained in the Enigma machines, or encryption machine, made by Nazi Germany. It didn't take him long to crack the code in the Enigma machine by creating an Enigma code breaker called the Bomb, which created in 1939. Alan Turing worked hard to get his machine, the Turing machine, into an automated computer machine at the National Physical Laboratory. But it was never achieved. Then he moved to the University of Manchester, where he made a manual for the MADAM, or Manchester Automatic Digital Machine. Next. All right, next will be presented by Windy.
Thank you, Eliza Ife. Eliza is a chatbot that was developed in 1966. The Eliza effect is the tendency to subconsciously perceive computer behavior as analogous to human's behavior. The Eliza effect is the term used to describe progressive artificial intelligence. This is the idea that people may mistakenly attack the meaning of symbol or words that they ascribe to artificial intelligence and technology. Many associate the term Eliza effect with the Eliza program written by Joseph Weizenbaum in the mid-1960s. Eliza was one of the first example of chatbot technology that come close to passing the Turing test, that is, to fool human user into thinking that text response were sent by humans, not computer. Many chatterbots works by tracking a user press and spitting it back out in a smart looking form. And in the case of Eliza, Weizenbaum used the concept of a Rogerian psychotherapy to provide a text response. For example, to a user inputs, "My mom hates me." The program may return, "Why are you sure your mom hates you?" The result of this program can seem very intelligent and very impressive for the time when humans were first engineering all system. The Eliza effect can be useful in building a complex system, but it can also mislead or confuse user. The idea may be useful in evaluating modern AI systems such as Siri, Cortana, and Alexa. Next, please. And the last, using chatbot to teach English. In the development of technology, there are many ways found to help teachers to teach English. Technology provide easier way to train the ability of English for students. One of the technology that can be used is chatbot. Virtual chat support is designed to provide instant answer to student question. Student can also automate text such as
submitting a segment, replying to emails, texting her message, feedback, and more. The teacher also can use chatbot to train the student ability, for example, to train the vocabulary and grammar. The teacher can ask student to do a conversation with the chatbot application. Using chatbots in educational application to assist student has made learning fun and improve their experience. So the student will not get bored of studying English by listening to the teacher. They will find new experience by using chatbot. Chatbot will provide immediate answer, so when the student have conversation with them, it will help the student to think faster about what shall they answer about the conversation. Back to moderator.
All right, thank you for all my friends that present the material as well as festival. I think it's enough for the presentation today. Thank you for your attention. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.